Well, in World Cup year, it's appropriate this weekend we can catch up on one of the players who was in England's famous side of 66. A player who scored in the final and last time England reached the World Championships. Earthling Borough, next to the A6, is a far cry from Mexico, but that's where Martin Peters played this weekend. His team, Galston, had Wembley in their sights. They'd reached the last 32 of the FA Vars. Martin Peters is 38 now, but the years haven't changed him at all. He still weighs in at 12 stone 3, exactly the same as he was in more than 700 league games and 67 appearances for England. Well, this is some way from the international stage, but when there's a Wembley place in the offing, commitment is total. Names and reputations count for nothing. The tackles go flying in. It really was fierce out there. Pretty tough for the referee as well, and occasionally he needs a spot of advice, but perhaps hardly the arena for a player with Peter's gifts. But you've got to be able to look after yourself as well. It's all hustle and bustle. Watch for Peter's here. Well, was that a deliberate elbow? Certainly referee Kelvin Morton thinks so. Sammy Morgan, Galston's number 10, is the second international on the field, totally involved as well, and Sam got a booking for that. But both internationals were caught very much on the hop as Earthling Borough, with a fine cup pedigree, broke away, and watch Carrilla here, chipping a goal that Peters himself would have relished. Well, Martin Peters came more into the game in the second half, but all his efforts came to nothing. His presence, though, had swelled the crowd to nearly 600, but it was Earthling Borough, in fact, who scored again at the other end. So Martin Peters came off, his Galston side had been beaten 2-0, and the dream of a final Wembley appearance had been shattered.
Yes, very disappointing, but there are lots of good sides in this, lots of tough sides. We were living on the hope and the dream, but unfortunately the bubble was burst.
Mm. What are your immediate ambitions now, your immediate plans?
Well, my immediate plan is when I move back to Norwich to just be happy and my family to be happy, and at the moment that's where it is. If the opportunity to get back in the game somewhere, I would love it. That's why I'm trying to keep fitness, keep my mind ticking over within the game.
You would welcome a return, for instance, to football management that you tasted, albeit briefly, at Sheffield United?
Well, I think I'd like to go back in as a coach if I got the opportunity first, and then progression to a manager. But to be honest with you, I've had one or two offers from lower division teams to play. And I didn't really want to play in the lower division. I do believe that I still could play in the higher divisions. Bawley's still doing it, so I don't see why I couldn't.